Hello and welcome. The Ravenfield modding community is flourishing even without official mod support. There is a modding channel on the official Ravenfield Discord chat server, and you can try out things like shooting infinite bullets, speeding up the game instead of slowing it down, or making the gravity moon-like, for example. Or you can even disable the third-person falling feature of Ravenfield. I am going to show you how you can, as a complete beginner, get into modding yourself. This will allow you to mod Ravenfield, but also other Unity games. So make sure to subscribe for more news and tutorials surrounding Ravenfield, and hopefully more game modding in the future. First things first, we have to set up some software. So first, let's get set up by getting the software that we need. Download ILSpy from its official website. Just press download binaries and it will start downloading. The next step is to get Reflexel. Again, go to the official website, press the download button, and here scroll down a bit, and you should maybe double check that the version is compatible with the version you downloaded of ILSpy. And in this case it is, so just download Reflexel for ilspy.aio.bin. Once you have done so, make sure to extract both of them. And the zip files you can actually just delete. Then go to the Reflexel folder and copy or cut the .dll file and put it into the ILSpy folder. This is all you need to do to install Reflexel, which will allow you to modify code, while ILSpy will only allow you to browse it and extract it. So now you are pretty much set up. Just double-click ilspy.exe and allow it to run. Now, in case on the left there's something open, just click it and press the delete button, or right-click and press remove until everything is empty, and then go to File, Open, and here you have to navigate to the location of Ravenfield, which usually is C, Program Files, x86, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Ravenfield. Just open this, and in there go to Ravenfield Data, and then go to Managed, and in here, make sure to make a copy of the assembly-csharp.dll file. Right-click it, copy, and paste. Alright, and now double-click or click and press open while selecting the assembly-csharp.dll. So now here we have a code, just press the plus to open it up, and open the item that has the dash. In here we have all kinds of stuff. Actor, which just means soldier in Ravenfield, Airhorn, which is one of the secret weapons, Boat, which is one of the vehicles, Car Horn, which is one of the sounds. So next up we're going to modify a weapon by injecting some code. So to modify a weapon, for example, by injecting some code, let us scroll down until we see Wrench, or we can also write Wrench on the keyboard. And over here, we just right-click the wrench and pick Inject Method. Now BlipBloop, from whom I learned how to do this, recommends to use Late Update. This depends on Unity. It's a function in Unity. So let's just write Late Update, make sure to write it correctly, and press OK. We can also unfold wrench, and we can see Late Update now exists in here. However, we cannot edit this code directly. We need to do it differently. Now let us open Reflexel by pressing this cogwheel, and in here we have instructions. We have only one item, which is return nothing, and let us right-click this and press replace all with code. This little window shows up. Now what we're going to do here is write additional code. For example, this repair health equals 1000. Then we need to compile this, but you will need to pick Unity/Silverlight for it to work. There we go, just press OK. As you can see, this code has been transferred to instructions. And now, to save all this, scroll all the way up, right-click on assembly-c-sharp and save as. And the file you have to pick is assembly-c-sharp.dll. Press save, press yes. And now let's see how this affects Ravenfield, or whichever game you are modding. To test this more easily, let us do a game without any bots at all. They will just get in the way. And let us get a dagger and a wrench. So the tank, if we enter it, we can see it has full health. Let's get out and shoot it. Alright, it has approximately half the health now. So let's shoot it again. Okay, so we are, let's see, 3 bars and a tiny bit down in the health. Let's get out and let's heal it. Alright. Now, this is amazing, because the normal healing speed is much slower. And I can show you this real quick by just going inside of the Ravenfield Data Managed folder. Let's call this Wrench Good Heal. And let's make a copy of assembly minus C#, because we're gonna need the backup for later anyways. And if we test the game now, we can see the normal rate of repairs. So as you can see, our change made a difference. So let's delete the C# DLL and replace it back with the mod we created. And now in ILSpy, if we go to Wrench and Late Update, you can see the code is not here yet. This is because ILSpy doesn't update automatically. So what we can do is reload. And then unfold again, go to Wrench, unfold again, go to Late Update, and here you can see the code has been updated. You will have to do this from time to time. So let us have some fun now. Let us actually create something weird instead of just something overpowered. Let's go to Late Update again. Let's go to Instructions in Reflexil again. And we're going to go right-click here and say Replace all of code yet again. And this time we're going to write this repair health equals minus 1000. Remember to compile with Unity/Silverlight and press OK. And again, we have to overwrite the assembly C# file. Save as, assembly C#, yes. Back to Ravenfield, let's see what this does. Okay, this vehicle is completely zero health, but it's still alive for some reason. We can take away health here, we can take away health here, and so on and so on. And you know what? I have an idea, actually. Let's sabotage the vehicles for our teammates and watch them blow it up. Just a little touch of a wall should do the trick. Come on, show some of your skills. There we go. That quad only had to touch the wall to blow up into heavens. Well, that was a great start, I think. Next up, we're gonna modify instructions instead of replacing them with new code. Alright, so the next thing I want to try out is something simple. Because I love playing around with sounds, let's go to the car horn object. So just scroll down a little, car horn. What we want to change is the last fired timestamp. For this, let's go into shoot, which is when the sound is getting played. That's what Unity calls it. And down here we have 13 instructions, which more or less represents the code there. Now, these things, I'm not sure what they actually are, but Googling them helped a lot. They are apparently CIL instructions, Common Intermediate Language instructions, which is an assembly language. Anyways, we can see here get time, which is time.time, I assume, and we can see last fired timestamp, which is the left side of that. So I'm guessing ldarg.0 might be the equal sign, and we want to just delete these three things so that hopefully we can play the honk sound of the Jeep indefinitely. I'm not sure if that's what it means, but let us just select these because they all happen after play and before return, and delete them and hope for the best. But this is what we made backups for. So now I'm just gonna save as the assembly minus C#.dll, and it is time for another test. Here we are, let's rush to the Jeep. Yes, we can do it. We can honk without interruption. The next thing I wanna do is to recreate a mod by Miles.fm, which surprised me at its usefulness, the speed up mod. For this, we're gonna go to the FPS actor controller. We're gonna unfold it. It's a huge object. There is so much code in there. So I already kind of know where to look. We need to go to update. And of course, we don't want to replace all this code because possibly we cannot even use most of this. I'm not even sure. So we're gonna have to kind of look through this, and the piece of code that I wanna replace or modify is here, which modifies the timescale. If time is less than 1, then timescale becomes 1, and otherwise it became 0.2. So if you press B or caps lock by default, I believe, then the time gets divided by 5. This is the slow-mo effect of Ravenfield. And what I want to do is change this 0.2 to a number larger than 1. So let us look in here for 0.2, because we can change numbers easily. And here it is. So let's right-click and press Edit and just write, well, let's say 2 in here and update. And that is basically it. Let's just save as assembly and OK. All right, so let's test if the speedup works. I'm going to press it now. And I'm going to press it again. All right. So something is broken. We can turn on this super fast mode, but we cannot turn it off. And I'm going to show you why. So first, let's update this loaded DLL file so we can actually see the code that was changed. So we're going to go back to FPS Actor Controller, and we're going to go to Update. And if we scroll down, we can see if time is less than 1, then time becomes 1. Otherwise, or else, time becomes 2. So the problem is this if condition doesn't work anymore. So the problem is, because this was oriented at slowing down the time using a number lower than 1, this doesn't work anymore. So we could actually set time.timescale to 0.999 in the awake function, and then later work with that. But there's an even simpler way. We can simply change the number by which this is compared. So we're going to say, if timescale is less than, edit this one, 1.1, then it must be 1. So we want to change it to the number 2. In all other cases, we want to set it back to the default, which is 1. And now we're done with this. Let's go up here, save as, assembly minus C#.dll. And now we can press B to turn on the fast mode, and B again to turn it off. This is assuming that you have it configured in input as B, the slow motion button. So now I can just speed through this boat trip with my fellas here. Oops. And I can unrepair the boat meanwhile. So let's see what happens if we touch ground. I think it's gonna be fun. Yep, this happens. And that is basically it. Ouch, I don't know what happened here, but never mind that. So much for simple changes when you know where to look. In the next part, I'm going to show you kind of how to creatively approach a situation, how to find out where to look if you don't know where to look. All right, so how do we find the code that you want to change? We can basically just go through the names here and guess that battle camera, that might be spectator camera perhaps? Or is this third person? I don't know. We could look at the code, try to figure it out. We can use Control F, for example. Third, no. But there is a way to search through all the files. Basically, all these objects represent code files. And this is by going to File and pressing Save Code. And then you can just create a new folder. I highly recommend you do that. Go in there and press Save. This will take a little bit. And then you can go back to the folder, which contains assembly-c#.dll. Go to the code folder, and here you can just search through the files. For this, I recommend a tool called grepwin. You just enter the path in here, and then you, for example, let us search for falling. In Actor, we can open this with, in my case, I assign it to Notepad++. Both grepwin and Notepad++ are free and open source. So let's see, where's falling? So now we see falling flag, but somehow that's the only mention, I guess? Falling? Yeah. How about on back? Also only once. Okay, update ragdoll. So ragdoll, perhaps we want to look at ragdoll. Ragdoll, oh, I see. So if this ragdoll is ragdoll, this fall over. Fall over. Could this be perhaps a thing we need to change? And indeed it is. The fallover function, public void fallover, is what we want to modify to turn off or change the falling over effect when you get shot or you fall down from a height. And we could also try to verify this by doing fall over. In the search, we can see it's only an actor, which has 5 matches, and an FPS actor controller, which has 1 match. Let's go to FPS actor controller, go for fall over, search for fall over. And this is just calls it, so this is not the file which we are interested in. In fact, actor.cs is what we are interested in. So let's go back to ilspy and actor, and it's alphabetical, so that helps. Okay, fall over, here it is. So this is a lot of code, and usually I would say I'm not comfortable replacing this with code. However, because all I want to do is disable the fall over function, I will just actually do that. Replace all with code and compile it immediately. So this doesn't work. So let's forget about this. Instead, we're going to do the instruction modification again. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select everything but ret. Thanks to NewSB for pointing out that even the first instruction is not needed. And just going to say delete. All right, and that's it. And that is really it. We can just go up here back to assembly minus C#, save as. And now let's test it in the game. So let's just jump into this plane and get up high into the skies, and then eventually we're gonna just jump out of it. And the expected behavior would be that we fall, and we start falling in this weird third-person perspective mode. But if we now just jump out with F, we can just keep shooting, flying, hey there, and we just land and it's fine. And for example, explosions don't make us fall over also. But they still make us die, so this is something to consider. We would have to do something more advanced in the modding to actually make us invincible, only us invincible, as opposed to making every character invincible. Alright, so much for the basics of modding in Unity. Getting more proficient will allow you to make more advanced mods like blip bloops, invincibility, infinite shooting, low gravity mod, for example. Just check out that low gravity. Yeah. Hello, buddy. Yeah. Nice. I would like to thank NewSB, MilesFM and Blip Bloop, who in my perception have been the main players in Ravenfield modding so far. Alright, so I hope you enjoy your first steps at modding Ravenfield or any other Unity game for that matter. If you think this tutorial was useful, make sure to give it a like, so I know that people want more. And with that, I hope to see you in the next video about Ravenfield and what the community has been up to, or maybe some other modding tutorial. Until then, ciao!